already sewing, or do you want to learn? Welcome to Power Sewing.
Hi, I'm Sandra Betsina.
And I'm Ron Collins.
Welcome to Power Sewing. What we're going to do today are some alterations on patterns that are not just such straightforward patterns. Most of you have conquered some real simple styles. But how about something like this that's a cardigan? And like, for example, this is what I am wearing. Now, this is a cardigan. Whenever I make something that has a separate bodice that hooks onto a skirt, I would always make this up in a little pretest of something, because what you want is you don't want the seam to be over the bust.
Now, is the length you have here the length?
Believe it or not, it's the same length here. But you see, these girls, they're so, all that when they take a picture of them, they're so thin that they make things look long. So what I would do is, if I were doing pretesting it, I would just pretest the bodice, because what you want to do is to see how far down this comes. Now, I did some changes on this pattern, and then I'm going to show you how to do them. This was the pattern as is. See, it has three-quarter sleeves, and to me, it looks like more like something a little girl would wear. Or, yeah, well, it wouldn't, or a little woman, but not me. Now, here's the version that I did. And so,
wow.
I lengthened the sleeves, I belled them out, I made the skirt more A-shape,
right.
And I lengthened the top. So let's see how to go about doing that. So the lower front we're going to deal with. Let's see, the back. Okay. So the first thing, the easy thing to do would be to just lengthen the front bodice. So what I'll do is, from the original, from the size, I'll just take and go along here, and I'll just add 2 inches to the bottom of it. Now, that means that this whole thing is going to be 2 inches longer. Okay, so there we are. So now that's altered, and I don't need to do anything else on that.
Would you have to do any? What about the back?
Well, that's what I'm going to show you. Here's the back. Now the back, I want this whole thing to be 4 inches longer. So do you see this one has a band, and then it has this bottom here.
Okay.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to lengthen this one 2 inches. I lengthen this 2 inches, so that means I need to lengthen this 4 inches. So let's start with the bottom of the front first. Now what I like to do on this is, let's see, I've got another pair of scissors. There's probably a bunch of them in that.
There.
The first thing we'll do is we'll lengthen this another 2 inches, okay? And then I want to flare it out. I don't flare out the top part. I just want to flare out the bottom part. Let's see now. So we'll take the 2 inches here. All right, and then we'll do two. Okay, there and there. Okay, so we'll stick that on. And you know what I try to look at when I'm pasting things back together? I want to end up getting the grain line in line.
So now, would you draw a line and continue
right.
it?
Right. And so, would you like me to do that
yes.
so you can line it up well?
Please.
Okay. All right.
Let's pot here, you know.
Okay, there we go.
There we go.
Now, we've lined up the grain line there. And we'll just put this 2 inches in. So now the length, where we've essentially lengthened it 4 inches. But remember that other one was kind of, you know, it's just kind of straight feeling. And what we want to do is we wanted to give it a little A shape. Now, if I just added to the sides, what would happen is it would just stick out at
right.
the sides. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a couple of little swings in here. And so this is the waist, okay, where it goes to attach the front. So what I'm going to do is take this and, spread it out.
And you're doing this at the sides, right?
Not on the side. Well, now I'm going to do all the way across.
Okay.
Watch, I'll show you. I'll have a whole bunch of them. I'm going to make of them.
Do you need another strip of
yes.
tissue?
Yes. Yeah, give me a whole one that I can put behind it. You see what I'm saying? Because what I want to do is I want to cut three of them.
Okay. So we're going to take the entire lower front and just tape it to another piece of tissue.
Okay.
So to do this, you can do them evenly, but see, I just maybe divide it in threes. Let's put this tape on the top of here so it doesn't come loose. And I'm going to spread it. And you know, any of you who have a tummy or if you have large hips, you can even spread it more. I'm going to spread each one an inch. So I'm going to give the front an additional 6 inches.
Would you add any more than 3 inches?
Or is sure.
You could?
Okay. I mean, if you had somebody who had, you know, 50-inch hips, right. I'd probably put another one on there.
So you'd tape this down,
right.
Add an inch.
And see, I'm going to, on each one, I'm going to add an inch. Usually I spread them an inch. Let's tape that one on the end first.
Okay.
Usually I spread them an inch, and then if I need more, bring it in a little bit.
Okay.
If I need more than an inch, I do another cut. Okay.
So you're adding 3 inches to one side and then three
so
to the
side. So what does that mean?
Six.
Bring it in. That means essentially I am going to add 6 inches to the front.
Would you have to do this to the back?
Yes, I'm going to do it.
Okay.
Now, see how it looks like it's wobbling a little up there. If we just continue our cuts almost to the line,
and just keep them hinged.
Yes, and what it'll do, I always call a little hinge on the end. So there we go. So that now we have altered our front. We've lengthened the front, and we've made the front swing out.
Now, does anything happen with the grain line?
No, the grain line stays the same because, see, that's in
still
line with the center front. Okay? Now let's take the back.
Okay.
All right, now the back, what do I need? I want it to be the same. I want it to be, first of all, I want to add 6 inches. Okay, the same, but I also want to add length. And so, what I have to do is I'll do just what I did before. Remember how I added 2 inches here? That would have been, it's just about the same place I added it at the bodice. And I'll just do it 2 inches here. And then we'll begin to swing it out. Maybe bring it up here a little bit because we need a little bit of room there. Okay. So, and I know you're going to want a lineup line.
That's right.
So there's your center back.
And that's cut on the fold.
Uh-huh. But see, it would be very tempting just to add this whole amount at the side seam, but then it would just hang there like a little lump. Okay, so there is 2 inches.
Okay.
Because anybody who's tried this with like an A-line skirt, I remember I would try to flare it out and I think, oh, that looks awful. And I'd always end up getting rid of it. Okay, so that's good. Then let's do two more here, and then we'll cut it apart again. Now you're going to say, oh, this is kind of a lot of work. But you know what I feel like? It's not that much work. What's work is making something and not wearing it because it's just not that flattering. So this is for anybody who just wants it a little more swingy looking. Okay, so there is the length. Oh, did this one come loose?
Yes.
Okay. All right, so we'll get that down. Now,
so
our next
two
thing.
Two here and two here, that's four.
That's four, because remember, we added four. We added,
two
see,
there,
we added two here.
And then two at
and
the
two
bottom.
Here. Okay. Now what we have to do is we have to do that spread. I'll draw some lines so you feel not nervous. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring it. Now, you want to decide, where do I want the swing to start? Do I want it to start under the armhole or maybe a little higher? Some of you have a lot of fullness in this upper back. And so this is how I would do it. I'd go into the armhole like this.
About at the double notch? Would
yeah.
Be,
mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then I would, because I think the whole thing is going to have a nice swing to it. Okay.
Oh, I see.
Excuse me.
And you do three of these.
Uh-huh. Now I'm going to begin to cut up through these cuts.
Okay. And why did you angle it?
Because, you see, if I would have gone straight, then it would have started flaring right under the neck.
Okay.
And I don't really want it to flare. I want it to start flaring maybe 4 or 5 inches down from the neck.
You just go Within a 5/8 inch.
Well, I go to about a quarter inch. So it'll lay down.
Okay.
And you know what? I think I'll just tape it on here momentarily.
To the blue.
Because
cardboard.
I think people can see better on the blue.
So this is going to give some width in the upper.
That's right.
In the back.
That's
as well.
Right.
And it won't affect the armhole.
No.
Which could be an issue, couldn't it?
Yes, but we're not going to. Now see, if we take this and we do this thing where we spread it an inch in each one.
Oh,
okay,
very
see how
nice.
It looks?
Yes.
Now there's one catch.
Okay.
Take a look at this bottom edge. Do you see it's here, 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 and it goes up? So what I would do with this is this is going to match the front. So what I would do is I would just bring this over. If this is the short one.
And add length.
Do you see add length to that one? Okay. Goes across there. See
just
this?
Basically truing up.
Yes. All right. Now there's one other thing we need to think about. What about the sleeve? I mean, if we're doing all this, we don't want this little sausage sleeve.
Right.
So let's fold that real nicely.
Okay.
And then here is the sleeve.
So this would be if you also you could do this adjustment if you're suffering from a large upper arm. Right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Let's see now. Well, let me see the sleeve here. This is the, okay, sleeve 29.
This is the
1058. Oh, that's the one we want. Okay. Now, the first thing, I think the sleeve was too short on the other one, you know. So I decided I wanted to add 5 inches.
Right.
I added just 3 here, and after I did it, I thought, I think I'll make a little more.
So we're going to add 5?
We're going to add 5.
Okay.
So what we can do, see, we want to start kind of flaring this out.
Now, when you're adding 5, would you do it in 2 places?
Well, I'm going to do this. I'm going to bring this down,
okay.
And then I'm going to flare it out.
I see.
You see, so what I'm going to do is kind of keep it the same up above.
Mm-hmm.
But let's say you had large arms. Then we'll bring it down here. Well, I'll do it with my slits, okay? So what I want, I know I want 5 inches on here. So I could come down 5 inches like that.
Mm-hmm.
And then, now I don't have to have as many cuts as I did earlier. But I just want to give it the suggestion that it's the same kind of sleeve. So so what I do with this is I can take my grain line, do it like this.
Extend it.
And I can either spread it or, do you see, I can shape it out.
Right.
I think what I decided that I liked was to bring it here, and then I made like a little flare.
Oh, so you came out, what, about 2 inches
yeah.
there on
yeah.
either side?
See, and then this one I flared higher, but I kind of like this. But now the other thing you could do is cut and spread,
right.
So just like I did before. But we'll bring this out like that. Now, the one last thing is when you're doing this, you want to make sure that those two match up.
Also fold them together.
See, fold them together. See how that doesn't?
So would you come out to the biggest one? Probably.
Right. Yep.
So you okay. See? Add to it. Maybe we flip it around.
Because you want the sides to match.
There we
and
go.
And you, okay, now. So now we, when we do that, we scribble this one away.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now there's one other thing. If there's going to be a hem allowance, see, I'll have to add a hem allowance on here. Let's say of an inch. How do I give the hem allowance the same
right.
shape as the rest of it? It's such a cool, easy thing to do. You
because
add your
hem would be too small for the circumference
that's
of
right.
the sleeve, right?
So see what, that's right. Okay. So I'll just fold it up like that, a hem allowance.
And you can do this too with pants.
Oh yeah, it's wonderful. So just get rid of that. And we're going for the big one.
Yes.
So what we have now is we have this sleeve that kind of echoes the shape. Now, as I said before, if you wanted it to be fuller, up in here, there's our little hem. See, mm-hmm. see how our hem allowance now
you
has this shape.
Get rid of that, right?
Uh-huh.
And this, you know, I wish I would have known this 20 years ago.
Oh.
Because you try to hem something and there wasn't enough hem allowance.
And you're always clipping open the seam allowances. But just let's just take a look at this and say, now what one of the things you can do is you can measure that sleeve, do you see, and see if it's big enough for you. See how this kind of comes down here? Some women's arms get larger down here.
Now what would you need for wearing these in a knit?
I usually, a lot of times a knit is minus, but I think most of us don't like, I have an inch in here. Right. So do you see, right down in here in the problem area, I'd measure, let's see, this measures about 13, okay. You see in there. And what you do we have a tape measure? Is one of the things I do is I will take a shirt that I like the feel of, and I will lay it down and flatten it out. See this one, the pattern, see this one is like this. See, and let's say this was my favorite shirt, all right? And this measures 14, you see? And I like it a little bit, if you wanted it a little bit bigger, so you could just fill that in a
right.
little bit, okay?
So you'd go 14 inches plus whatever seam allowances do you need.
Yeah, so you it's kind of flat. And I tell people you can measure it right under the arm and then down about 3 inches, depending upon where. Right. So now when you make this, it'll be something that you're excited about rather than something you make and you say, oh, it's too short, let's do this. And then, you know, this had a little facing, like a little belt inside that had a long tie. Well, all I did is I laid this piece of braid on top of the belt. And then I always look for these little antique closures.
And that also supported this heavy buckle.
Oh, yeah,
right?
That's why I put that on there. Now, I'd like to show you a few other things.
Okay.
Would you like to see?
Friend.
Okay. All right, so now let's get a little more interesting here. Okay. Here is the pattern that, well, let's do this one first, because this one. All right, here's this pattern. This is such a cute shirt. And people just love it, including me.
1165. I remember when this one came up.
See, and it's got pleats here. Now, how did I turn it into sleeveless? I just eliminated the sleeve. My armholes are higher already, so it's not going to show your bra. But I'll show you when we get this out if you wanted to make it sleeveless. But it was real simple. I just didn't put the sleeve in and put some binding on. Now, let's say some people love this shirt so much that they decide to fold the pleats out and make a plain one. Mm-hmm. They just really like the silhouette, and that's how you do that. But one of the things that you might want to do when you get something fitted like this is do a little flat pattern measure. Let's see how much it has, not how much we hope it has. So we start here at center front. You see, let's say the bust is always the problem. So we're not going to get anything past center front. So I come over here, and it's 9 5/8. Now let's come over to the back, and in the same area. Okay, 9 5/8. I'll start 5/8 over.
Okay.
And the same area. Hold on a second. Let me see, turn around like this. Same area, and now I can go to the fold. So this is about 19 3/4. So that's
times it by two, right?
So that would be 39 1/4, mm-hmm. Okay? So that means that this blouse has 1 1/4 each ease. You may want a little bit more or a little bit less. Mm-hmm. Some people just may need a little bit more. So that is very easy to simply add, do you see, at the side seams.
Another seam allowance.
Yeah, you could just add another seam allowance
and
there.
And also do the same thing
right
on the
here. Back. You can make it 2 inches. And you know what I try to tell people to do is you're so worried. I know you don't want to make a pretest, and I know you don't like to measure.
Mm-hmm.
So what I tell people to do is add 1 inch of fit insurance on each side, baste it together, and see how you like it.
What would you do? You're not putting a sleeve in here, so you don't have to worry about
Well,
that.
If I were putting a sleeve in here, I have two choices.
Okay.
Okay, let's say I've added a half inch to each one. Okay, so that gave me 2 inches more. Now, my sleeve.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I have a choice. I can add the same half inch under the arm,
okay.
Which is going to give me room down here. But if I just have kind of a full arm all over, I can cut it down the middle and add an inch.
Spread it that way.
Do you see?
Right.
And then maybe your notches move, but that's the most important thing when you put in a sleeve is one thing, this dot.
to match the dot.
The shoulder. And that's right. Really, really important. And then the other thing is, some people say, well, I want to shorten. Like, for example, if you're short-waisted, or if you want to raise the dart and things, maybe you want to fold out some things like this.
Okay.
Now, when you fold out things like that, what in the heck do you do with the pleats?
I would say this? Put a ruler at the
That's
end
exactly
of that.
That's exactly right.
Put a ruler here and just true it up.
See, because look, everything's dandy until they start going on the diagonal.
Okay,
here it is.
You have the ruler.
I see these are matching up, but now it starts to get kooky.
Right.
So right here, I would correct. See, just sketch them together. And then, let's see, this one is here. So just, you might want a longer ruler, top to bottom.
Mm-hmm.
But what you want to do is move over that line.
Now, if you do this, what I love about this pattern, it has a bust dart, but it mm-hmm. doesn't get involved with the pleats.
Right.
But you can still raise and lower this bust
dart. Oh, yeah. You want me to show you a coolest way?
Let's see.
This, most people, it's lower, a lot lower. So what I do is, I discovered this years ago. Let me just show you this. Let me just cut this loose. If you are, let's see, okay, we'll just let that loose there. All right, let's say your bust point is an inch and a half lower, okay? Mm-hmm. So what you can do is you can take this, draw a line above the dart. People love this because it makes it so easy. Now, this
see, could, about an inch and a half above the dart there.
Uh-huh. And let's just say pretend here. Oh. I slide it down an inch and a half, okay? Now the dart is lower.
But you made the front longer too, right?
Right, but then what I do is I just fold out the 2 inches under the dart.
So whatever you added on here, you take out below.
Yeah,
smart.
And so then you don't have to redraw or do anything
smart.
Like that.
Very nice.
Now, let's say something else. Let's say you're large busted. And everything hikes up. All right. Let's say you're large busted and low busted. You've got it all going on. A lot of people do.
Now, how can you be high busted and low busted at the same time?
Well, no, but you know, they're full. Well, this is going to be the low busted, but I'm going to show you a low big bust.
Hello, big bust. Okay.
I remember my husband and Dan and Ron and I were talking last night. And he said, well, you know, women's figures are not easy. There's a lot of curves to go around. Now, see, here's the dart. And I'm going to draw a line right in the center of the dart.
Okay.
Then when I get past there, I go straight across. Now, remember, your pleats do not have to be folded out to do this. Now, I come here and I cut. You see right across here, and it's a half inch per cup size. So here we are. See, we add our half inch there, and then how do you sew the dart? See, it's all the way across.
This dart would continue right up into the center front.
But all we do is we redraw it. See, we'll have it end at the same place.
Okay.
But we just redraw the legs like that and like that.
So this increased it by a whole cup size.
Yes.
Wonderful.
And so it's, you know, I mean, you mm-hmm. can do a lot of things. Mm-hmm. Now, here's another thing that I see on so many people, narrow shoulders. But what they do is they take and they cut off the armhole.
And wouldn't that kind of distort this?
Yeah, that creates problems. So we're going to talk about that. First of all, okay, this is the blouse that I just, the sleeveless one. All I did is I sewed it as it is. But if you had a garment that had a lower armhole, mine are that European armhole, it's higher. But if you had something with a low armhole, then and I wanted to make it sleeveless, I would just raise it a half inch.
Do that in the front and the
back. And the front and the back. But don't do that on this pattern because it's okay.
Okay.
Okay?
That's just for
but
the
now,
bad patterns.
Now let's talk about the other issue, which is the narrow shoulders. Okay. Now, let's say we have narrow shoulders in the front. And the back, see what happens is everybody cuts this off and then the back is a problem. Mm-hmm. So what you can do is, let's say the shoulder seam, you wanted to take a half inch off, or 5/8. Okay? We're only going to take it from the front, mm-hmm. only. And we come down to nothing by the notch. Okay. Now the back, let's find a back here.
The back is here. Here's the back.
Oh, there's the back. Okay, so what am I going to do with the back? How? See, this is now going to be longer.
Okay.
Now, if I cut it off, that's going to make it feel too tight. So what I can do is I can either run an ease line, or I usually do this. I take, and in the middle of the back, right around that little notch, I draw a line 3.5 inches long,
okay.
and I make a dart that's exactly the width
of what you added into the
back. Uh-huh. So can you see that mm-hmm. now? I fold this out. So that's gone. And now that
will match up.
Fits the front
right
with the arm. And when you're just taking off of the front like that, it doesn't really affect mm-hmm. the size of the armhole. Mm-hmm. And it just makes it really comfortable. Let's see, I guess, here's, hold on, I have it backwards here. So it goes like this, okay?
And you could run, if you're just at taking off a little, you could run an easement stitch.
Oh, yeah, so whichever, yeah, yeah, was if
the
yeah,
fabric
that's the
will
thing.
Kind of determine that, right?
Yeah, like Lynn and I would put the little dart mm-hmm. in, so it's in the mm-hmm. middle of the armhole. The middle of the shoulder, and right. it's 3.25 inches long. And or 3.5, it doesn't matter. And then just whatever you took off here, put it in the dart. But those are just a couple of little things. As we move along, I will show you other things. But this blouse is a wonderful blouse, and you want it to fit right. And so if you wanted to make a little pretest of it, do you see what you could do is you could fold all the pleats out and just make a front and back bodice. But if you add that fit insurance at the side, you won't have to. Well, I hope you like that show on alterations.
So what do you think?
About what?
Power sewing.